rigor mortis was first noticed in. See, we have the rigidity of the muscles. The rigidity of the muscles normally after a state of what is called death. So the complete contraction stature of the body after death is called rigor mortis. So it is a state of stiffening of the muscles after death. This is process of actually permanent cross bridges between actin and myosin filaments. They fail to separate. Cross bridges are the structures which are normally formed during muscle contraction. They are formed permanently. They are not being separated so that there is no muscle contraction. So the muscles attain a state of contractility. So most important cause of rigor mortis is non-availability of ATP, the source of energy. And also this is what is called creatine phosphate, phospholate ADP. Rigor mortis begins with the eyelids, neck and jaw. Just we have the eyelids, once actually death occurs, it never closes. We have to close it immediately, otherwise it's always kept open. So then we have what is called the neck region and jaw, and both together. So rigor mortis begins with the eyelids, jaw, the neck. We cannot just actually open the mouth in the case of person who has gone, what is called, who has lost his last breath, and that is what is happening. So it is noticed in the eyelids first, then the jaws, and also we have neck region. So rigor mortis was first noticed eyelids, then jaws and neck. But once actually happening, though the eyelids you can close it even after some time, but the neck ones form the stiffness occurs first in the neck one, and then only it's moving up the jaws and eyelids. It's going upward direction, neck, jaw and eyelids. And other parts of the body are actually being stiffened only after some time. Neck is the first part.